camera one, get a close up on camera three. Hello and good evening. Welcome back to the Oval. We have few things to talk about given the eventful week leading up to tonight's episode. We will be discussing the Keystone Pipeline spill in South Dakota, as well as the 2017 American Music Awards. Tonight we will also have two special guests, solo artist Jack Webster and slam poet Gabe Membreno. Let's get right into it. So the Keystone Pipeline in South Dakota, it spilled over 200,000 gallons of oil, I believe. 210,000 gallons of oil. So obviously that was very detrimental to the land in South Dakota. And first off, I'm unclear, as I know it's, I read something about it was in Nebraska, but the spill was in South Dakota.
What happened was is that the spill happened in South Dakota, and while when that happened, they were deciding on whether or not to extend the Keystone Pipeline into Nebraska, and that decision happened today. They decided they will extend into Nebraska
despite the 210,000
gallons of oil spilling everywhere. They still went ahead and did it, and I mean, that just makes no sense to me. It's like when the BP oil spill happened in 2008, they didn't go right ahead the next day and, you know, build another oil rig next to it and, you know, go ahead with that.
Can we break down, like, what, to begin with, were the pros and cons of this Keystone Pipeline? Because, frankly, I only see the cons, so I'm curious
if anybody else sees a pro.
One of the biggest pros is that we're not as reliant on our imports anymore from Saudi Arabia, especially. This is economically sound, although the pipelines have a history of bursting. If you look back at 2005, other pipelines, bursts like this do happen. And, you know, it's simply the cost of business.
But I don't think, my thing with it is, the oil is to be extracted regardless, but is that pipeline necessary? Because it covers such a large scale, it covers so much land, so the chances of people's water being contaminated is higher, people's land being destroyed, crops being destroyed, livelihoods being destroyed.
But it's not the only way oil has to be transported, but it is the most efficient way to modern day that we could transport that oil.
The pipeline starts in Alberta, like that, because they said apparently there's a lot of natural oil reserves up in Alberta where it starts, like, toward the northern point of the Rocky Mountains in Canada. So, like, and they wanted to...
And it stretches all the way to New Mexico?
It definitely goes through, like, the mid-plain, the mid-states.
Like a kind of frontier region of the
this
U.S.
This particular oil that they're taking from Alberta, so it results in 14% to 20% more greenhouse gas emissions than oil typically consumed in the U.S. in present. Mm-hmm. So this oil isn't, it's not like, it's the regular oil that we have been refining. This is oil that will increase greenhouse gas emissions 14 to 20%. So I'm just...
There's
very few benefits as to why we're getting this oil from. And I mean, I guess you could say the trade between Canada and the U.S., that's pretty cool. Except, you know, there's only so much that does.
Except that it's the oil that's in Alberta, that's in Canada, isn't oil it's different than the oil that we're currently
refining. But going
refining,
on
like
Ruben said,
worse.
Yeah. It helps us rely less on exporting oil from different countries. And also, apparently, not saying I believe it's a pro, they say, like, you know, it creates more jobs because of the longer the pipeline is, the more people they can work on it. And
these jobs
in terms of outsourcing jobs, it'd be less of that. More
these jobs that they claimed that they would create aren't jobs. They're just the contracts for how long it's going to take to build the pipeline. So let's say the pipeline takes 2 years. Those contracts only last 2 years, and then the 42,000 people that they promised jobs are out of jobs because it only takes 50 to 100 people to man this particular pipeline.
Well, that's how construction works. You don't get a company doesn't get a contract and work on that, say, house, for example, house forever. I used to work in construction. So you build a house, like, or renovate a house, 6 months or so. After you're done renovating, that's the end of the contract, and you gain a certain profit from that 6 month period. So that's the jobs we're creating. We're giving Americans jobs in the other day, and like you said, you know, less jobs obviously to sustain it. But when there's bursts like this, obviously it's a negative on our environment. It's a negative for the people
exactly.
who surround
so
it.
But our temporary
it also creates
jobs,
more jobs as well to patch that up.
But are temporary jobs worth all of
yeah.
the
construction
things that
jobs are temporary jobs, but I'm trying to tell you guys.
Right.
Well, yeah,
well,
it could affect future
that,
generations.
But what we're saying is this a good enough pro to continue this type of negative impact?
I don't
is
think so.
Is this a good enough pro? No.
I feel like
I think the money it brings our economy is a much larger pro than the small amount of jobs that it does create. I'll give you that it is a small amount of jobs.
But is a temporary pro a pro at all?
Probably.
I don't think so.
But moving on to a more lighthearted topic, now we're talking about stuff that went on last night, the American Music Awards 2017. American Music Awards has definitely risen up in the ranks in terms of like one of the most watched broadcasts in terms of entertainment throughout the year. And it was a lot of huge winners last night. What do you guys think about the broadcast last night?
I have something to say, and Marlene and I talked about it beforehand. She hates Selena Gomez.
Okay, I wouldn't say hate. I don't hate her.
I thought it was a good performance.
It was a cool setting.
I don't know her to hate her.
I just don't like her.
Guys, yeah, she showed up to the AMAs after reports had come out saying that her and Justin Bieber are dating again with blonde hair in an all leather outfit. That's just the greatest thing I've ever heard in my entire life.
I've heard of greater things, like Tracy Ellis Ross.
She was
hosting
amazing.
That was the best mother-daughter duo.
Yeah.
Diana Ross.
She also
living Lifetime Achievement Award.
She kept on changing outfits, and that kept on like just like confusing me a little bit. Oh, but it was still iconic. I love her.
Yeah, and her performance, Diana Ross's performance, was crazy. Just cements her legacy in the entertainment industry. She's been around forever. It was amazing.
I don't know if everyone saw it, but I mean, you obviously love Selena Gomez.
Okay. Now I feel a little bad about it. I don't love her. She's obviously not the greatest person.
You don't have
in the
to
world.
Feel bad about liking somebody, but
I just think it was great that she came out after all of this hype around
and
her.
And I think
like,
it was
not
I,
with
no,
a man.
Yeah.
Like she didn't come out like
and
with
it
Justin
was,
Bieber.
It
she
was
came
her
out
first
with, a new
with
herself.
It was her yeah. first performance all year, I think,
yeah.
because
yeah.
she was dealing with
Lyme disease.
Lupus.
Oh, I'm sorry. Lupus. Yeah.
Yeah.
Also, we were talking about.
She hopped on you, real quick. No, lupus.
Like, guys, get your facts straight about
this.
No, we were also talking about Christina Aguilera's performance.
Yes.
Yeah.
So she gave a tribute to Whitney Houston, and that got mixed reactions because a lot of people said that they would have appreciated a black artist giving a tribute to Whitney Houston,
yeah.
and a lot of people I felt like were trying to equate Christina Aguilera's talent with Whitney Houston's, and I don't think that that's what they shouldn't have done that
yeah.
because obviously nobody could compare to Whitney Houston.
Yeah. Whitney Houston has her own, you know, very special sound that she's kind of had all this time. Christina Aguilera is wonderful too, and you know, if she performed a medley, then she performed a medley in, you know, the way that she did it, and that's what makes it unique about her performance, which, you know.
Yeah,
also, she's
but
very
I
influenced
definitely
by
understand,
her,
yeah.
Which is why. It, like, it was meant to show her, like, Christina's idol, like, she idolized Whitney Houston.
Yeah,
yeah.
That's
I feel
why
like
chosen.
It's have African-American women, how many places are there? How many times have we proven that African-American women aren't awarded the same opportunities.
Half of the things, no.
Not nearly half of the things.
Because we were talking before the show and we were thinking just Jennifer Hudson.
You're telling me that her voice isn't,
yeah.
I mean, not no one's comparable to Whitney Houston, but that her voice couldn't stand up, that Christina Aguilera is the only woman in Hollywood whose voice could live up to Whitney Houston.
Didn't somebody say Alicia Keys?
I said Alicia Keys.
I disagree with Alicia Keys, but I think Christina Aguilera's resume is like, large enough to have not filled Whitney's shoes, obviously, because they're two different artists.
Yeah, right.
But
I
her
mean,
resume is large enough to have that performance.
I enjoyed Christina Aguilera's
performance.
I thought she did.
But I do understand why people were kind of on the fence about it. But
I mean,
you can't expect everything also to be color coordinated. Just because she was a black artist doesn't mean you can't have an artist of a different race have a tribute to her, because she affected more than just one community.
Yeah.
And I don't mean to say that you guys are, you know, insinuating that only, you know, it has to be
called
a woman.
No, not at all.
But
right, of course.
But overall,
why not award the position to a woman who wouldn't have the same opportunities anyway.
Overall, it was a great show. I enjoyed it, but
love Selena Gomez.
Whatever.
Okay, but yeah, I'm glad we got to talk about that. But moving on, we're very excited to have Oval's first slam poet, Gabe Membreno, followed by solo artist Jack Webster. So we're back. We're hanging out here on the Oval. We're hanging out with slam poet Gabe Membreno, and Gabe's going to perform a couple of things from us. But first off, so Gabe, when did you decide you wanted to pursue poetry?
I started writing poetry probably when I was a freshman in high school.
Cool. Okay.
Just reading a lot of poets in school then got me inspired.
Is there like anything in particular that inspired this poem today?
This poem is about the race dynamic between me and my mother, and I use coffee as a sort of metaphor to kind of strike
that. I'm excited for that.
Yeah.
Who's your favorite slam poet? Who's your biggest inspiration?
My favorite slam poet is this guy named Hanif Abdurraqib. Absolutely marvelous guy.
And what organization are you affiliated with?
I'm here with technically both the Poetry Slam Association and also the slam team for this year.
Okay.
Yeah.
Great.
Awesome.
So
excited.
I'm excited too.
Coffee's origins are rooted in Ethiopia and Yemen as early as the mid-1400s. It is said to have been brought to the Dominican Republic by Frenchman Gabriel de Cluse in 1734. But coffee has been growing in the Dominican Republic since 1715. Hispanic family history is digging for your roots, finding that each one has your colonizers stained into them, their mark etched into your ground, spelling out, "How does home taste, kid?" I've grown used to this. Afternoons in a Starbucks line, awaiting my name to be nixed by someone who doesn't know what to call an angel or refuses to believe that I am one when I approach the counter and order, let me get a dark roast, black. If it wasn't for the concern on their face, I probably wouldn't have to add a routine. Nothing else, thanks. It is easier this way. Protecting myself from the question of why I do certain things, like drink black coffee, or hate the lighter parts of me, or stray from sweetness, or avoid explaining to my mom how those aren't in the same vein. Yet I find us pouring our respective beverages in a gas station mart, my large cup dark, and her showing me her milky drink saying, "Look, son, how white." The words, they pass through me the way she passes in this country, the light Dominican. Aloud here until her accent lets out, the smoke signal rising from her mellow mug, warning me to speak only when ordered to or when ordering coffee. Make sure to state your name. Gabe, short for Gabriel, the messenger, delivered to get it through that I don't know how to get it through. This old name was given to my new body as if I'd ever want to own anything not mine in the first place. I don't know how to speak when it concerns me. I'm told that I was plucked out of heaven, planted in my mother's soil to grow unwavering, break through a dirt that stays on skin, and this name given to me as a right, shared with a man who claimed to bring bold to this land, thought the darker ones would enjoy roasting under a sun that they hadn't quite yet figured out how to stop worshipping. I sit here at the end of a line of coffee makers, hearing them talk of home as any place that's still lingering on your tongue, but I hear the whispers of the men who made us love our labor. You Dominicans are so bitter. Don't you love the taste of fresh ground? Mom asks me how I drink something so strong, so dark. She tucks her ancestors behind her ear before she tells me, "You should try something sweeter, son. Your heart won't burn so much for what it has never known." Thank you.
I'm speechless, honestly.
Thank
that was
you
great.
So much.
Yeah, I was really passionate. It was crazy.
Oh, yeah.
So welcome back to the Oval. We're hanging out here with musical guest Jack Webster. So Jack, how's it going?
It's good, man. It's really good.
Awesome. So as an artist, if you had to say this, what would be your dream collaboration?
I would definitely have to say Stevie Ray Vaughan. I mean, you know, like, I know he's not around now, but, you know, like, that was just a guy that I drew, like, and like a lot of my playing from.
Legendary guitarist.
Coming up, yeah.
Definitely. And how long have you been playing for?
I've been playing since I was like 12, and I only started singing like probably like two or three years ago.
Okay. Dope.
Awesome,
so
sick. So excited to hear it.
Yeah, man.
Excited.
Ain't no sunshine when she's gone. It's not warm when she's away. Ain't no sunshine when she's gone. She's always gone too long. Anytime she goes away, wonder this time where she's gone. Wonder if she's gone to stay. Ain't no sunshine where she's gone. This house just ain't no home. Anytime she goes away, I know. Hey, y'all, leave the young thing alone. 'Cause ain't no sunshine when she's gone. Ain't no sunshine when she's gone. Only darkness every day. Ain't no sunshine when she's gone. This house just ain't no home. Anytime she goes away, anytime she goes away, anytime she goes away, anytime she goes away, anytime she goes away. Well, they blew up the chicken man in Philly last night. Blew up his house too. Down on the boardwalk, they're ready for a fight. Wanna see what them racket boys can do. Now there's trouble busting in from out of state, and the DA can't get no relief. Gonna be a rumble on that promenade, and the gambling commissioner's hanging on by the skin of his teeth. Everything dies, baby, that's a fact. But maybe everything that dies someday comes back. Put your makeup on, fix your hair up pretty, and meet me tonight down in Atlantic City. Well, I got a job and I put my money away, but I got the kind of debt that no honest man can pay. So I drew out what I had from that Central Trust, and I bought us two tickets on that Coast City bus. Everything dies, baby, that's a fact. Maybe everything that dies someday comes back. Put your makeup on, fix your hair up pretty, and meet me tonight down in Atlantic City. Now our luck may have died, and our love may be cold, but with you, forever I'll stay. We'll be going out where the sand turns to gold. Put your stockings on, cause it might get cold. Everything dies, baby, that's a fact. But maybe everything that dies someday comes back. Put your makeup on, fix your hair up pretty, and meet me tonight down in Atlantic City. I've been looking for a job, but it's hard to find. There's winners and there's losers, and I'm south of that line. Well, I'm tired of getting caught out on that losing end. But I talked to a man last night, gonna do a little favor for him. Everything dies, baby, that's a fact. But maybe everything that dies someday comes back. Put your makeup on, fix your hair up pretty, and meet me tonight down in Atlantic City. Oh, meet me tonight down in Atlantic City. Oh, meet me tonight down in Atlantic City. Meet me tonight down in Atlantic City. Won't you meet me tonight down in Atlantic City?
Hey, thank you, thank you.
In constant sorrow all through his days, I am a man of constant sorrow. I've seen trouble all my days. Bid farewell to old Kentucky, the place where I was born and raised, the place where he was born and raised. Oh, 6 long years I've been in trouble, no pleasure here on earth I found. Poor in this world I'm bound to ramble, I have no friends to help me now. He has no friends to help him now. It's fare thee well, my old true lover, I never expect to see you again. For I am bound to ride that Northern Railroad. Perhaps I'll die upon this train. Perhaps he'll die upon this train. You can bury me in some deep valley, oh, many years where I may lay. And you may learn to love another while I am sleeping in my grave. While he is sleeping in his grave, maybe your friends think I'm just a stranger, my face you never see no more. But there is one promise that is given, I'll meet you on God's golden shore. He'll meet you on God's golden shore.
Hey, thank you. Thank you.
That was a great performance.
Hey, thank you.
Yeah, awesome. Do you have also original songs you're working on that you're gonna put out maybe anytime soon?
I've got like a few that I'm like, you know, like playing with.
Awesome.
It's coming, like, I mean, it's kind of slow, but like, you know, like, still fun to just like, you know, like try to like, you know, like write,
yeah,
and stuff and like, you know, like make like new music. So
thanks for coming on the show. You
yeah,
were really
thank
good.
You so
thank
much.
You.
Yeah, that was a great set.
Yeah. Of course, man. Thank you for having me.
Yeah, no problem. Anytime.
That is all the time we have tonight. I want to thank our guests, Jack Webster and Gabe Membreno, for coming on the show. Thank you so much for watching and have a great night.